Welcome again. Remember, this is video 3 of the Pricing Your Cakes for Profit video series. Well, I hope by this time you have watched video 1. So in this video series 3, which is the last video for this Pricing Your Cakes for Profit series, we are going to talk about how to get customers to accept the prices you give them. Now, this is a very informative video, so take away any distractions, reduce the volume of your TV set, your phone on silent, because what I'm going to show you today will really benefit your business. But before I get started, I just want to give you a quick recap on what we spoke about in the previous video series. Remember, in video 1 we spoke about the reasons why you may be struggling with prices, and I told you some methods on how you can overcome it. And also in video 2 I gave you some simple methods on how you can price your cakes. And remember, and you know, the methods I gave you are quite easy, and you can implement those techniques or methods right away. So I hope you found those two videos informative and educative. So I hope now you're starting to get more confident in your pricing your cakes or baked goods, so that you don't get scared anymore when you have to give a quote for a cake. I mean, you can easily and quickly provide a quote for a customer without any fear or apprehension. So in today's series, I'm going to reveal strategies on how you can get customers to accept the price you give them for your cakes. So imagine a world where, like, when you give a quote or a price for a cake, the customer says yes, please, and readily accepts. I mean, you don't have to be afraid, you don't have to be scared about saying a price. You can confidently say, oh yes, my 8-inch eight inch buttercream cake costs 8,000, and the customer readily says, yes, I want that cake. Okay, now I may be exaggerating a bit, but not every customer you give a price to is going to say yes, you know. But I'm going to show you a technique which is used by most marketers when they give a quote for their products, and using this technique is more likely you will make a sale, because it's all about turning your inquiry into a sale. I mean, your aim is that any inquiry you get from anybody that calls you or emails you or Instagrams you or Facebooks you and say, oh, I want a cake, you want the end result to land a sale, to say, okay, to order a cake. So there are techniques, so you have to know how to close a sale from beginning to end, because it is a process. Now, as I said before, now this technique is used by sales people, my marketers, you know, and it has proved very effective. I mean, in essence, we are all marketers, we are all salespeople, if you really think of it. I mean, we are in the business of selling cakes. That is how we make our money. So you know the price you want to sell, but you know, sometimes we get afraid. The customer will reject us price, saying that, oh, your prices are too high. So do you know what you have to do? Well, I would tell you, don't let the price be the first thing you say. Now, what do I mean? When someone calls you for inquiry and says, okay, for instance, she wants let's say a frozen cake for her 1-year-old daughter. Now, one, tell them the reasons and benefits of what you are offering. Make them motivated, and you know, let them be motivated to have a reason to buy, and make sure you are talking to the decision maker. So these are things you should keep in mind when you want to land a sale. There are three things. Tell them the benefits, the reasons, what makes you stand out, what's so special about the cake. Make them motivated. Don't let your voice be dreary, or like if you're tired, you know, get them excited about the party, about, you know, the theme or whatever occasion the celebration is for. And make sure you're talking to the decision maker. Now, I'm going to talk about these things one by one so you better understand. So you need to provide reasons why you are the best. I mean, why are the best? Tell them you can tell them that, oh, you have done a lot of those type of cakes. Ask them about the theme of the party, the styles of the cake. You can show them pictures of, you know, the awesome cakes you have done, or maybe you have had some celebrity clients, or you know, or maybe you've been in the cake industry for a number of years. You know, do it with so much confidence and enthusiasm. You know, tell them that, okay, maybe you can add even something extra, maybe a box of cupcakes in the same theme, like in the same frozen theme, and that you can decorate the cake table, or that you deliver the cake for free, or you know, just think of any additional, you know, benefits, you know, that you are offering. So you are already showing her all the added benefits she'll be getting from ordering from you. So that, you know, so that will now give her, you know, the motivation and reason to buy from you. So if you say that, okay, if you order a cake for me, I will give you a dozen cupcakes, and she'll be like, okay, it's like you're getting two baked goods for the price of one. I mean, who doesn't want a deal? And so, and once you're saying this, make sure you are motivated. I mean, ask her questions, you know, if they're having a party, ask her, I mean, you have a party planner, what is the theme, you know, tell her that you two, you have a young daughter, and you have also done that party theme, that, oh, and then maybe you can make some suggestions and recommendations. You know, this is just getting information, you know, making them be drawn to you, making them not just a customer, but you seeing them as a friend. So the third is like, okay, make sure you're talking to the decision maker. So for you to determine, because you do not want to be saying all these things and be talking, and in the end, you find out that, oh, maybe you're talking to maybe the secretary of the person who wants to make the order, or maybe, you know, or maybe someone else. You want to be talking to the person who is actually going to pay you, or even if it's not the person that's going to pay, but the person who has made the decision. So for you to determine if the one you're talking to is the one that can make this decision, I mean so that after all the talking, and then, you know, you don't want situations she says that, oh, I have to ask my husband, oh, I have to get back to you, oh, I'll call you back. You know, we don't want all that process. We want that, oh, from the moment you pick up home, you want to close the sale. So how do you determine if that person you're talking to is the decision maker? Well, for one technique you can do is like, okay, that you're looking at your booking date or your diary, and that you have, you know, you have to get the impression that you are busy. I mean, you're not a hobby baker. Say that, okay, that she's lucky that, oh, that date is free for you right now. And then she makes the booking now, you can throw in something extra, maybe like a dozen cupcakes, but you can only throw in that offer if she makes that booking now and makes a deposit, you know, that same day. So if she says, okay, how much is the deposit, you know, she has to make, then you know that, okay, that aspect, that decision is under her control. And usually, it's usually women that do the ordering of cakes, especially birthday cakes, anniversary, and all those type of cakes. So usually, it's most times it's the woman that has that decision, you know. So, but if she says she has to check back with her husband, you know, it has given excuse, you know that, okay, she's not prepared to order from you. So, you know, you can cut that conversation off. Once she starts giving you the excuse, I'll have to get back to my husband, I'm not sure, then you can now get the feeling that, okay, maybe she is not your customer. So you can just cut your losses and say, okay, I hope you'll consider us in the future and all that. So, you know, you don't really have to bother continuing the conversation. But of course, don't be rude and drop the phone. So now, let's say you have now determined this, that, okay, the one you're talking to is the decision maker. She's the one, she has the money to pay for your cakes. Now, how do you do to land the sale? Well, the first option is that you should present two price options. Because I'll explain in a moment. It's good to close the sale, it's good to present two price options. Now, the first option usually is the high price option. This is the very, very high price, you know. But in the price you are including a number of things the customer may or may not want. I mean, you're fishing here. I mean, the objective of this price offer is to create a pricing contrast with what you feel is the right price. You can say that with this price package, I will give you something extra, including of the cakes, including, you know, the cake she's ordering. You can add some cupcakes, you can add maybe some cake pops, you can add maybe some, you know, you can add some cookies, you can say you decorate the table for free, maybe you say that, okay, if it's a party, you can provide like props, like a cake stand and some, you know, all those little decoration. I mean, just think of something extra that you can put in, but make sure that you are not going to be out of pocket. Make sure that cost is also included in the cake, is covered in that price. Now please do not be scared to present this high price. Remember, you're going to give her another option, but you never know, she may accept this high price. You know, I mean, if you present this high price, they'll be shocked at first. They'll say, ah, this place is too high, you know, but that is what you want. However, on the other hand, do not be surprised, you know, if they're taken off, like, okay, with this price I can get this. I mean, if you list all the benefits and all the things she's offering, like, okay, no, you know, we're talking about value. You know, you'll be surprised that maybe this, that's when you present a higher option, you may at this point, you know, get a sale. Now of course, if she says that, okay, oh, this price is too high, oh, my budget is so, you can now then present the second price option. You tell them, because this is really the price you want to sell. I mean, you have done your pricing, so this is really the price you want to sell, which is of course is going to be lower than the first price option. This is the price you want to sell the cake without any negotiation. I mean, this is the price you want to sell the cake at that price, and you're not going to reduce it any further. Remember, you've already reduced it. You have reduced it from that high price option to now this. To this price that you are going to sell. Remember, you are selling, not negotiating. And of course, you should be confident when you're talking. As I said before you sell, say the price, tell the buyer the benefits that they're getting. Remember, you are solving a problem for one. You know, I talked about this in the previous video series. You have to think of what problem they have and what problem they have that you are willing to solve. So for this, you need to allow them to talk. Ask them about the occasion. Remember, you know, a party is a happy occasion. I'm sure they'll be happy about talking about, you know, all the things they have, the preparations they have going. You know, the events, the number of people expected, you know, because maybe they may not know the exact size of cake they need. So you'll be like, okay, how many people are you expecting? How many cakes? How many, you know. So as you listen, we begin to assess what solutions you can provide. Maybe she doesn't have an entertainer, you know, you can refer somebody. Maybe you can offer desserts. Maybe the cake she wants, you know, will not go around. Or maybe she says she wants to keep some cake at home. You can, cake from cake at home. You're like, okay, why don't we do desserts, you know? Or maybe say I'll do a smaller cake, you know, like a sample cake, so that you can keep that at home in case all the cake is eaten up at the party, you know. Or you can say, okay, maybe there are older people at the party and may not like cakes. Okay, maybe I can provide like a fruit option, things like that, you know. I mean, you get what I'm saying here. You know, from a conversation, you start getting pointers of what she needs, things that she may not even have thought of. So that's why you have to be very, you know, you have to listen. And once you listen, you know, just be making notes and think that, okay, she says this and this, I can offer a solution for this. So that is how you should present your price. I mean, first of all, it should not be the first thing. Let them talk first, you know, talk about the benefits and then present your price. So as I said earlier, after you've talked and said all what you have said, you have presented to them in a confident manner, you know, the first offer, that is the high price package. After you give it to them, you know, be silent, allow them to respond. You know, they will say, ah, that price is too much. And then, you know, if they object, state again that with confidence that you have one other offer which you feel is best and which is within their budget. And then you give them the second offer, and then, you know, you can say all the things that is still in that second offer. And then you tell them the price. And then, you know, at this point, it's good not to talk too much, because we do not want to talk too much and then put them off, you know. So once you have said your second offer and you have given them the benefits, given the benefits and your second offer, you know, just keep quiet, you know, do not talk, allow them to speak first. Now, the confidence you give or portray at this point is critical. Let the customer speak first, and usually they will. If they object to your prices again, you know, again, say with confidence, that's okay. Even if they say, ah, this, your price is too long, you know, you are a busy lady. I mean, your cakes are in high demand. You have quality cakes, you know. You can just say that, okay, I've gone through my diary and I have a free spot for you. There's a free booking. That if you make this booking now, just ignore that they have objected. That if you make this booking now and secure this order by paying, you know, just a small deposit to essentially what you're doing is ignoring what they said before and going in, you know, just to close that sale, you know. So they're objecting, but you say, ah, no, that okay, I'm quite busy, but I still I have a I'm free down on Saturday, and if you secure that order right now by paying this just a small deposit, I'm going to add you something extra, you know. So they'll feel like, okay, you know, usually, you know, they should say yes. I mean, if they say yes, you have an order and you can, and you quickly send in your invoice with your account details and make sure they pay in that deposit that same day to secure the order. But if they still reject your price, they object, you know, do not negotiate or give them any inkling that you are open to negotiating, because you have a goal. You want to sell your cake at that price. You know, don't say that you're, don't let them think you're open for negotiation. Don't say, ah, no discount. I mean, you have already given them a discount. You have given them the high price offer and you have lowered it to a second price option. I mean, you have tried for them. So if they say no, that's out of my budget, you know, just thank them politely for their inquiry and hope that they'll consider you in the future. And, you know, just, you know, end the conversation, say bye, thank you for considering us, and, you know, we hope to hear from you soon in a polite manner, and then, yeah, and let them go. So, but please, please, please do not feel bad if you do not get the order. I mean, you'll be surprised that, you know, maybe one day, you know, they will come back and then agree for the price. I mean, how many times that they'll say no, and then then maybe a day or so later they'll call you and say, okay, I want that cake. So the worst mistake they can do is to start negotiating. Do not do that. Any reduction in your price, you know, it reduces the money you're going to make. Remember, you have a target. I mean, and you know, it has to cover your costs. You have to pay yourself. You need to make profits for your business. So do not think that they are the only customers. Your mindset should not be one of scarcity. There are many customers, as I said, there are many fishes in the sea. There are many customers, and each one of us has our own customer. So do not worry. If they say no, move on to next one. Market until you get that order. So that is it for this 3 video series. I do hope that you have gotten a lot of informative techniques and on how you can sell your cakes better. But this video is not yet finished yet. Remember, I said that you have to stay to the end. But before we go, I want to invite you to this free webinar that I'm doing. I'm going to be holding this free webinar, and it's on this topic on how to increase your prices without losing customers. I mean, we need to increase our prices at one point. At one point in our business or the other, cost of ingredients are increasing, but sometimes we are afraid to increase our prices because we are scared of losing customers. Well, in this webinar, I'm going to show you how you can increase your prices, your cake prices, your baked goods without losing your customers. Now, this webinar is for bakers, cake business owners who want to make more money in your cake business. Remember, with more money you have more money for yourself, more money to invest in your business. So in this webinar, you will learn the strategies on how to increase your prices without losing customers. As I said, prices of ingredients have increased, but yet customers still want to pay low prices for our cakes. Well, so how can you keep up? How can you grow your business? I mean, are you afraid of increasing your prices because you want to keep, you know, the customers you have? Are you out of pocket for most of your orders? Are you, you know, losing customers because you just increased your prices by maybe just like 5%? Are you using your own money? I mean, are you losing money and using your own money to buy ingredients? Are you now using cheaper and substandard products because you can't afford buying more quality ingredients anymore? You know, and all this affects the taste of your cakes. I mean, have your profits gone down? So that's why you need to register for this, and that's why I'm inviting you for this, you know, informative webinar on how to increase your prices without losing customers. And in this webinar, you're going to learn 3 things: how to increase your prices without losing customers so that you can stop losing money. Another thing you're going to learn is how to communicate an increase in prices to your customers so that they keep on coming back, and how to turn an inquiry into a paying customer at the price you want without sounding desperate. Remember, I've given you one strategy here, but there are still a number of strategies on how you can turn an inquiry into a paying customer. So do not miss this webinar. All the webinar details shall be posted to your email. So whenever the webinar is, make sure you tune in and watch the video, watch me live, so that I will tell you how you can increase your prices without losing customers. So I'm going to teach you all in the quick actionable steps. So register for this webinar. I'm going to the posting details of this webinar. So put it in your diary, do not miss it. Put it on your phone as a reminder, so that you can, because once I post this